I'm Simon and I'm here at AirBeamTV to get you started mirroring your Mac to your Hisense Smart TV. So let's get into it. First things first, we need to install the AirBeamTV onto our Mac. So we do that by heading to the AirBeamTV website, clicking Mac, scrolling down to find our TV make, which is Hisense, clicking through, and then downloading the app. Hot tip, why not download the trial first, see if it works for you. And once it's installed, we simply need to open the app. So let's do that now. So once it's open, it will pop up in your taskbar at the top. And like it says, click the menu bar icon to get started. Install the audio driver. So in order to get the sound from our Mac to our TV, we need to install a special audio driver. This is very simple to do. This pop-up will guide us. We simply click install and it will take us to the installation window. Click continue, install for all computers, install. I'm gonna type in my password, please look away. And it's installed. Very easy. It's worth noting that we are running a regular Hisense Smart TV, but your Hisense TV might be running on Android or Roku. We can use the same app for all three of these, but if it's running Android or Roku, you want to install the receiver app on the TV as well for the best performance. Luckily, the AirBeamTV app will guide you through that process. So next up, we want to get things started by clicking on the icon in the taskbar at the top and clicking enable sound on TV. It'll give us a little pop-up that says allow access to microphone. That's so that it can do its special computer wizardry and send the sound across using that audio driver that we already installed. So I will click authorize and okay. And we are almost ready to go. So now we've installed the audio driver and, if necessary, the receiver app to our Hisense TV, we're ready to start mirroring. But before we do, we need to make sure we are connected to the same network for our laptop and our TV. And if your TV has it, ideally a wired connection for the best performance. So we click the app and under target device, you should see your TV listed. If necessary, switch it to Hisense Smart TV and then click Start Mirroring. Now it should take a few seconds to get going. There's a little delay, we call that latency. It means 1 to 3 seconds between things happening on this screen and that screen. It's basically fine for photos or videos, but it means you won't be able to do high intensity gaming. And there we are. That's my laptop screen mirrored onto the TV. So what do you want to do? Maybe you want to look through a presentation for your work, have it on a big screen so you can show everyone in the office. Everyone loves a butterfly effect diagram and a mind map and a SWOT analysis. Maybe you've just come back from a great trip and you want to show your whole family and friends some photographs. Well, you can absolutely do that. Simply pop them on this screen and they'll pop up over there. I went on a great trip where I enjoyed a cappuccino. Maybe you want to show videos from the internet. You can do that. And now that we have the sound driver installed, the sound will come out of your TV. Oh, look at this. It's a video about King's Day. I'm intrigued by this fella. Pop it on full screen on your laptop, and there it is. And the sound coming out of the TV. This looks really great. I'd love to watch the whole thing. But we don't have time. I'll turn that sound down and you can catch up with that another time. And that is how easy it is to mirror your Mac to your Hisense Smart TV. If you have any other questions or queries, don't hesitate to get in touch with us via Facebook Messenger or email. In the meantime, let's get it trending on Twitter. Happy mirroring.